Hello and welcome to today's Innovation Coffee Break. I want to talk about testing and validation of brake systems. A brake system of a car can be either tested by driving it or it can be tested in a testbench setup. A wide range of technologies are available when it comes to braking systems, especially for electric vehicles and hybrid electric vehicles. Regenerative braking is one of them. If brakes don't work in a car, it can be obviously quite dangerous, even if you have a prototype car and a trained test driver. The crossfading between regenerative braking and mechanic braking can also be a risk. So what can dSPACE do about that? Right, we can remove the whole brake system and place it into a test bench. How can we get sure to make the brake system work in a test bench as well as in a real car by using as many real components as necessary? That's what we have done here. Let me show you what we came up with. This is a dSPACE brake test bench. It is used in numerous of our projects. This part is called a wheel part compartment. It contains the parts of one of our customers who was so kind to let us show the ready-to-use setup. In the middle of the compartment, you can see the brake booster ECU, which is connected to the other parts, as well as to pressure sensors, brake discs, and force sensors at the back to measure the electronic park brake. The length of the brake pipes, which you can see in the middle, are the same length as in a real car. We have attached several pressure sensors in the circuit to check the brake pressure of every single cylinder. In order to test the park brake, which is in most cases electrically activated, we placed four sensors in between the brake disc and the caliper, so that you can check if they are able to do their job. The four sensors can measure up to 60 kilonewtons. That should be enough for almost any parking brake. The test bench is designed to test brake booster in every thinkable situation with a really high performance. The wheel part compartment is completely closed to prevent brake fluid from leaking into the environment. dSPACE braking test benches let you create the perfect test environment for virtual test drives to evaluate and analyze the real braking system. Anyway, did you ever do an emergency brake maneuver yourself? Then you will probably know that the brake pedal will vibrate during this process. That is because the anti-lock brake system will interact with your wheels. Besides the simulated environment, you will need an actuator which can realize this movement as well as your leg. For that purpose, we have developed an in-house linear motor, which we use for this purpose. So it moves in a linear axis and can be pushed back, and it can reach speeds up to 1 meter per second and forces up to 5,400 newtons. In order to test the anti-lock brake system, some might think you would need moving parts in terms of rotating tires. With our HIL environment, it is possible to simulate those wheel speeds like in a real car, just on simulated signals. On the left side, you can now see the brake actuator control layout. In this layout, the important settings and measurements are displayed. If you have two different types of pedals or brakes, the software adapts automatically by doing a homing. Here we can switch to our Asm control mode. Asm means automotive simulation models. In this mode, the test bench gets its set point from Asm, which simulates a car driving on a road. On the right side of the screen, you can now see motion desk and the simulated maneuver. On the left side, you can now see the linear actuator pressing the brake pedal accordingly. So, what can we say? We have a highly flexible, accurate, safe and versatile system which can perform an almost infinite number of different test scenarios. We can attach this system to almost every other dSPACE system to get an even higher level of test depth. And finally, you can automate your tests, which can save a lot of time and effort. Thanks for listening and goodbye.